stunt industry has become even more daring in recent years. The rise in action sequences is demanding more out of stuntmen and more out of the software that does what they can't.
You can't kill the metal.
Though stuntmen once viewed CGI as a competitor, it's now viewed as an aid on those stunts that are either too dangerous, too physically taxing, or just plain impossible.
But they failed, as they were smacked to the ground.
CGI comes in all sorts of places, from scenes that you can clearly tell are animated, like this one, to scenes that you have to rewind to see if it's actually the actor or not, like this one. Many action movies will frequently use real stuntmen in order to get the job done well. For example, Casino Royale used Freerunner founder Sebastian Foucan climbing buildings and jumping through construction sites to make the viewer feel like the scene was actually unfolding before their eyes, and it was very well done. The industry will likely never completely oust stuntmen. As realistic as CGI can get, the audience can still tell they're being duped. So stuntman has no need to fear losing his job. Likewise, the computer industry doesn't need to fear losing their stake in movies. Movies like The Matrix combine actual stunt work with CGI software to create a realistic feel to otherwise impossible action. Additionally, hardware developers need to keep improving computers so that they can handle the kind of taxing graphics these CGI programs can create. Toy Story was the first feature film that was completely CGI, but each frame took 2 to 3 hours to render. In actuality, that number hasn't improved much. As computers get faster, the software gets better, so there's more detail to render. Still, even today, it takes about 2 to 3 hours to render each CGI frame. Imagine that time plus the time it takes to animate it. As far as CG in movies go, the most popular company by far is Industrial Lights and Magic, or ILM. Almost any movie that has CG that you have seen or ever likely will see includes some kind of product by ILM. It's either done by ILM, done by a spin-off company of ILM, or it's done using some software developed by ILM. Some of the most used software by ILM currently is Photorealistic Renderman for rendering, Adobe After Effects, which all film students at Full Sail have, the most recent edition of, Mental Ray for watery things, ZBrush for displacement maps, which is what you will see people being animated with, including stuntmen, and Zenviro for camera mapping. All of these technologies will play an important role in the future of action sequences and the stuntmen that are animated therein. Overall, the action industry has come to rely heavily on both stuntmen and graphic artists to create the look of the scene they're looking for. Just like stuntmen need the gyms, though, graphic artists require both lightning-fast processors and great graphics cards, as well as software to create realistic physics and realistic motions in their people. As technology progresses, we'll likely see action scenes switching between stuntmen and CG animation nearly seamlessly. I hope you continue to be on the lookout for movies with awesome action, and look forward to the day where you can barely tell who is real and who is not.